Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can write algorithm to traverse a linked list. So before writing algorithm, let me draw a linked list so that we can use that diagram for our reference purpose. So suppose this is start pointer. Then this is our first node. This is our second node, and this is our third node, right? So node 1, node 2, node 3. So I hope you have watched my previous video where I explained you node is actually consisting of two things. First one is information, or you can say value, that we want to process, and second is pointer to next node. So this node's base address will be stored here, this node's base address will be stored here, and node number 1's base address will be stored here. So let's say I'm assuming the base address of this node is 1001, right? It is 2001, it is 3001. So this address will be stored here, 2001 will be stored here, 3001 will be stored here, and it will be null. So this way we represent our linked list in memory, and each node will be stored at different location, but they will be connected with each other address. Like second node address will be available with first node, third node address will be available with second node. So this way these nodes are internally connected, but physically they are available at different locations. Now let's say value or information is 10 for this node 1, this node 2 is having 20, and node 3 is having 30. So now we need to implement an algorithm so that we can traverse each node of the linked list and we can find out the information part of the linked list, right? So now I'm going to write the algorithm. So name of algorithm will be traverse. It will be requiring one parameter as start. Start will be the will be containing address of first node, then info, and link. Or here you can also write next, right? So this is basically this part of node. So it is containing address of next node. So you can write next or you can write link. Whatever you want to write, you can use here. Now, step number 1. So step number 1 will be set ptr equals to start. So PTR will be loop counter, which will be moving from one node to another so that we can identify the values. So start is having address of first node. So now we are assigning that address into PTR. So PTR is also pointing to first node. So we can write it here like PTR equals to 1001. PTR is pointing to first node. Then step number 2. So in case of step number 2, I need to implement a loop. So I am writing repeat steps. So some steps will be repeated here. So we are going to repeat step number 3 and 4, right? So two steps will be repeated, and condition will be PTR not equals to null. So if this PTR is having a particular address, then this loop will repeat. If it is equals to null, then this loop will be terminated. So this loop will repeat when PTR is not equals to null. So now I need to write step number 3. So in case of step number 3, I need to write a statement where it will look like we are traversing the algorithm. So here I can write process. Process can be, you can say count, or you can say print, right? So it can be anything. So I am writing, it can be values, it can be printing of values, etc. Right? So any process that you want to apply on these values, you can write here, then. So apply process to info of PTR. So info of PTR means PTR is pointing to this location 1001 and its information part is containing tab. So let's say here we are writing a print info of PTR. So what will be printed on output screen? Tab. Right? So PTR is pointing to this node, so we expected the information part. Now after printing that information, we want PTR to be pointing to node number 2. So how we can do that? So for that I am writing step number 4. So in case of step number 4, we need to set PTR equals to link of PTR, right? So PTR is basically pointing to this node, which is internally divided into two parts. So you can say it as next, or you can say it as link. So right now I consider it as link. You can also write next here. So whatever you put here, you can use it here. So PTR link is 2001 will be stored into PTR. So it means PTR is pointing to 1001. At this location, in this part, we are having value is 2001. So that will be assigned into PTR. So new value of PTR will be 2001. So this way, if you want to move from node 1 to node 2, node 2 to node 3, so you need to use these, you need to use this tab in your algorithm. Right? And here I am writing end of loop. So PTR is pointing to 2001. So here we need to check PTR not equals to any condition is true. Now print info of PTR. So info of PTR. So PTR is pointing to 2001. So its information part is 20. So 20 will be processed. And then again PTR equals to link of PTR. So in this case, PTR link is 3001. So that will be assigned into PTR. So its new value will be 3001. So again we need to check this. It is not equals to null. So again information of PTR will be processed. So right now it is 30. Then PTR equals to link of PTR. So PTR link is null. So this time PTR will be having null. Now if we check this condition, PTR not equals to null, so it is false. It means our process is completed and at step number 5 you can type end. So this way you can traverse individual node or individual block of linked list by moving from node number 1 to node number 3, node number 2 to node number 3. So I hope with this algorithm you understood how we can traverse a single linked list from a particular node to another. And if you want to know how we can convert this algorithm into a C program, so for that you can go to description of this video and you will find the link of playlist where I have uploaded all the algorithm converted with the help of C language. So you can watch that and you can understand how we can write linked list programs with the help of C language. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. Thank you for watching this video.